alcohol or somebody else's disorder. God says, come, just as you are. Bring all your burden, lay it down at my feet. And we make a detour. Finally, there is nothing. Then plop down. Then we say, oh God, why? Why? You could save all those time if you come straight to Jesus. Straight to who has a power to solve all your problems, power to heal you, who has power to liberate you, set you free. Come and receive. Drink the living water. Got it? Do not make detour. Go straight to the King. Then He will. Then you'll be a part of His miracle. Got it?
Got it.
And the last one is that do what God commands you to do and swallow your pride. When this guy showed up, Naaman showed up at Elisha's house, what did he have? $4 million in his pocket, king's letter, right, his armies and chariots and everything, boom, boom, showing up. Did Elisha came out the door? He was expecting Elisha to bow down before him, right? And stretch his hand and lay his hand on his leprosy and call upon his mighty God's name and heal him. No. What did he do? He sent a messenger, his assistant, out to tell this mighty guy, like Saddam Hussein, you know, mighty guy, go and dip yourself 7 times. In the Jordan River. Let's read the verses 11 to 12. It's really funny. Let's read it. He said,
but Naaman went away angry and said, I thought that he would surely come up to me and stand and call on the name of the Lord his God, wave his hand over the spot and cure me of my leprosy. Are not Abana and Pharos rivers of Damascus better than any of the waters of Israel? Couldn't I wash in them and be cleansed? So he turned and went off in a rage.
Rage, amen. His feelings got hurt. Here, he's a very important, powerful man in the whole world. And he probably thought to himself, I can kill you. You know, I am very important, and you didn't come out and go bathe in that muddy water. We have better waters in our country, and went away. And then God put the servants, who is faithful servants. See, this is God's plan for him. And servants says, sir, if a prophet asks you to do great things, wouldn't you have done it to cure your leprosy? Then, he would, yeah? He, after all, he brought $4 million, and he got this, he would. Then why not try? I mean, waters. And Syria is better, but it didn't cure you. You bathe in that water forever. Your leprosy is still there, so why not dip in the Jordan River? And he turned around, swallowed his pride, and dipped it. And then what happened? His flesh restored. He was clean like a baby. You see, in order for us to receive God's miracles, we need to humble ourselves. We need to swallow our pride. You know, pride is in the way of a lot of things. Between husband and wife, they can solve their conflicts because of pride. Kids rebel against their parents because of their pride. People, we share the gospel to unsaved people. And they say, what? I don't need the organized religion. First of all, I can worship the God of myself, and I am a good person. I am a good person. That's pride. Pride will rob us from experiencing God's miracles. So, this morning, I'm going to swallow my pride, risking myself to be ridiculed or laughed at, but I'm going to say what God told me to say, and I want you to do the same thing. Let your guard off this morning, and you listen to God's voice, and do not detour, do not make a detour, and swallow your pride. God said, there is somebody who is going through such terminal situation, hopeless situation, and God sent you here to receive His miracle. So you need to step up and come and let us know. Let the living God to know what is your situation. And God sent some of you with the gifts of healing, gifts of hospitality, gifts of generosity. God sent you here to use your gifts so that you can be part of God's miracle this morning. Now I say, you know how vulnerable it is to say those things? Every time we come to worship the Lord, it is a time for divine appointment. And the Spirit of living God is hovering over us. The only thing is that many times we do not realize. Many times we just make a detour. And right now, I don't know who that is, what problem you have, and God's Spirit asks you to step forward, and then you will receive God's miraculous healing of your body, or of your finances, of your relationships. I don't know. But God's been pounding your heart this morning. And come. Yes. Come just as you are.